Welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to share with you the topic that I have for you today. Today I want to talk to you about how to find the perfect network marketing company. This is a big one, guys, because we all want to make it work, and then sometimes we don't know what is happening and why we need to quit and jump to another one. So this is a really big deal. With so many companies out there and so much information on work from home business, how do you choose the right one? Well, I'll tell you how I have, in my experience, learned that people should do it. The first thing is that you have to acknowledge that this is a marriage. You cannot be jumping around, or you cannot have two or three. It is really hard to manage two or three businesses. I'm not saying that you can't do it, a lot of people do, but you will not be able to tell people that you have the best company in the world, that you have the best opportunity for them, if you're actually married to two companies. So, you know, a lot of the times, maybe up to two, three is already getting out of hand. So my first advice is love the product. Learn to talk about your product. Know everything about the product that they're trying to introduce you to. Will you be able to use it? Will you be able to take it? Will you be able to talk about it? Will you be passionate about it? And most importantly, what's gonna happen 20 years from now? In a lot of the companies, especially the company that I chose, you can inherit this business to your children and your grandchildren. That's why I do it, because every day that I work, I'm leaving something for my child. So if I'm gonna do this for the next 20 years or 30 years or the time that, you know, I'm gonna be doing it, and I don't know when it is. I know we all wanna make it from 2 to 5 years, but we don't know when it's gonna happen. So are you sure you're gonna be able to have the same passion to talk about it 20 years from now? So this is number one, love your product. Number two, love your company. Love your company is get to know everything about your company. Some people, they like high risk, some people like middle risk. So will you be able to actually know if the solidity that you need is there? So I'm not saying that older companies or newer companies are better. I'm just saying find the one that fits your style. In my case, I'm a middle-aged woman with one child. I want to make sure that my investment is safe. So every minute I put into my company needed to be safe. So I chose one that was already in business for 20 years, not 2019. But if you want to choose one of the new ones, they have great marketing, great incentives, but you don't know how long they're going to be there. We don't know how the product is going to be in the market. So you can go ahead and do it. There's lots of big bonuses with these companies. Now, the older companies, what I find is that the older companies, they have a lot of solidity and they have a lot of name, but compensation plans sometimes are lower because they have gained a lot of ground in the market, and so they need to have money for stockholders or, you know, other things. So you know, make sure that you know what you're getting into. How many years has your company been in business? What is the background financially? Are they debt free? You know, my company is debt free. They own every single building that they have in every country that they're in. How many countries are they in? Is the compensation plan seamless in every country? And all kinds of, you know, questions that you need to ask before joining the company. That brings me into the third point, compensation plan. This is the biggest risk of people. Most of the time people join companies because they think they can make easy money in a fast time. Network marketing is not easy, and you're not gonna make it in fast time. So compensation plans are the beauty of it. Most of the companies, I'm gonna say all of the companies that are legal and active, actually have great compensation plans, and you can make money with any of them as long as you understand the compensation plan and what you're doing. Compensation plans are formulas, exact formulas that tell you what to do to get where you wanna be and in how much time. So how many people are you gonna have to recruit and in how long, and how you're gonna divide them in your network marketing, if it's a binary or if it's a multi-level. So you need to know what I'm just saying right now. You know, what is, if you're asking yourself what's binary and what's multi-level, you need to study a little bit more compensation plans, because that means you haven't done your work. So once you know which of the compensation plans are suitable for you and you're able to explain it, so don't find a compensation plan that you're not gonna be able to even talk about and explain because you don't understand it, because you won't be able to sell it. And it's very important. And I know you always have your mentor, you always have an upline helping you, but it's important that you also at one point are gonna do it yourself. Now, the next thing that's the most important for me, your team. Number four, you're married to this company for the next 5, 10, 20 years. You need to love the people that surround you. You need to know the people, not only the person that signed you up, but the uplines above. Do you have a relationship with them? Do you have access to the uplines, and how fast do they answer your calls? How is the behavior that you have with your cross lines? Are you supporting each other amongst teams, or is it a team against team competition? Because this is not what network marketing is about. All of the network marketers out there, the professionals that do this for full time like I do, we know that number one, we need to all have the name really high what network marketing is. We all need to help each other. This is a new industry that people still don't understand, and we know that it works. So first of all, are you finding support from your upline? Are you finding support with webinars, with access? Do you have a group that you can go to? And in your city, do you have access to other cross lines from different teams that not necessarily have to be under your leg? And do you have access to communicating with them so that you can support? This is a business that you're never alone. You're never by yourself. You always have to have somebody cheering you on and having your back when you need a pat on it. So those are my four tips of today. Thank you for listening, and we can go in a little bit deeper. If you want more information, you can write me and we can go farther into this. All right, thanks a lot, everybody. Until the next one.